stones. No water, no trees, no grass, no nothing. So he put his wife there and he left. Then he made this dua. رَبَّنَا لِيُقِيمُ الصَّلَةِ رَبَّنَا لِيُقِيمُ الصَّلَةِ The first words of Sayyidina Isa عليه السلام قال إني عبد الله آتاني الكتاب وجعلني نبيا وجعلني مباركا أينما كنت وأوصاني بالصلاة. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala order our Nabi to order us. I mean, order our Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to order his family. And the order of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam order to every Muslim. وَأْمُرْ أَهْلَكَ بِالصَّلَاةِ وَاصْطَبْرْ عَلَيْهِ وَأْمُرْ أَهْلَكَ بِالصَّلَاةِ Don't ask them to pray, no. Order them to pray. And if you read the Quran, my brothers and sisters, according to the Salah, you will find the people four kinds. Four kinds Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describe the people according to the Salah. They are four kinds. Three kinds, they are in the hellfire. They are going to Jahannam. And one kind, they will go to Firdaus al-A'la. Three kinds. They will go, certainly they will go to Jahannam. And one kind, they will go to Al-Firdaus Al-A'la. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, let me start from the worst kind, what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala informed us. He said, في جنات يتساءلون عن المجرمين. Those believers, muttaqin, they are in Jannat. They are asking each other about al-mujrimin, the criminals. مَا سَلَكَكُمْ فِي سَقَرْ What caused you to be in Saqar? It's like, just example, when the people in the jail, and they see somebody, very bad situation. His situation is very bad. They ask him, what caused you to be here? شو مصيبتك انت؟ شو عامل؟ So the same thing, what caused you to be in Saqar? يا إخوان Saqar, you know what is Saqar? Saqar, a place in Jahannam. That place, if the person goes there, the moment he enters there, he disappears. Because it's so much heat, so much temperature. This, eats everything, bones, does not leave anything. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brings him back. Then he disappears. From where I take this information? From the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا سَقَرْ لَا تُبْقِي وَلَا تَذَرْ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, what do you know about Saqar? It does not leave anything. Means if the person goes there, his bones will melt, his flesh, his hair, everything in him will disappear. Then Allah brings him back. Then he disappears. Then Allah brings him back 70,000 times every day. So they ask him, what did you do to be in Saqar? مَا سَلَكَكُمْ فِي سَقَرْ قَالُوا لَمْ نَكُمْ مِنَ الْمُصَلِّينَ So anyone does not pray, he will go to Saqar? No. But those people, they have a quality of kafirin. They are kafirin. How do we know they are kafirin? Complete the ayat. قَالُوا لَمْ نَكُ مِنَ الْمُصَلِّينَ وَلَمْ نَكُ نُطْعِمُ الْمِسْكِينَ وَكُنَّا نَخُوضُ مَعَ الْخَائِضِينَ وَكُنَّا نُكَذِّبُ بِيَوْمِ الدِّينَ They were kafirin. They don't believe in the Yawmiddin. And from this ayah, the ulama, they said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask the kafir in the day of judgment about the details of Sharia. Means it's not enough just kafir go to Jahannam. No, the kafir will ask him, Allah will ask him, why you did not pray? Why you did not make zakah? Why? So those people, they are in Jahannam wal-iyadu billah, kafir, but he does not pray. There is people better than them in their situation. They believe in the salah, but they don't pray. What's your name, brother? Abdul Rahman. Where are you from? I am from Islamic country. I don't want to say something then. He will say, no, he's racist. He's talking about Pakistani. You know what? Say, I am from Palestine. I am from Palestine, so let him from my country, no problem. What's your name? My name is Muhammad. Okay, do you pray? Allah, ya akhi, the salah is very good. I'm asking you, do you pray? No, I believe in salah. But, wallah, you know, ya akhi, we are in Dallas. And I am recently came here. Let me just stand on my feet. Let my business establish. Inshallah, then after that, I will start praying. Wow. So those people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala informed us, they are in Jahannam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فخلف من بعدهم خلف أضاعوا الصلاة واتبعوا الشهوات فسوف يلقون غيا. غيا ابن عباس رضي الله تعالى عنه يقول واد في جهنم. It's valley in the hellfire. تستعيذ النار بالله منه في اليوم 70 مرة. The fire, the hellfire, seek refuge with Allah from this valley every day 70 times. The fire says, Na'udhu billah min ghay. Na'udhu billah min ghay. 70 times every day. Why? They don't pray. They don't pray. We have people, they are better than them a little bit. They pray, but they delay. They pray, but they delay their salah until the time of salah is over. MashaAllah, he's in the store or gas station, whatever. He has lines of people. He look at the watch, MashaAllah, I have another 10 minutes to pray. Dhuhr has 10 minutes. Oh, Alhamdulillah, plenty of time. MashaAllah, the last customer come, another customer come. Oh, 2 minutes, you know what? Okay, Al-Asr comes, Maghrib comes. Aisha comes, he goes home. ما شاء الله أكبر ظهر الله أكبر عصر الله أكبر مغرب الله أكبر عشاء. Give me the biryani العشاء يعني. So this man again والعياذ بالله الله سبحانه وتعالى mentioned them in the Quran. فويل للمصلين الذين هم عن صلاتهم ساهون. ويل in Arabic language ويل means woe to you. But other narration too, Wail is other valley in Jahannam wal-iyadu billah. But that valley, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, it has snakes and scorpions. قَالَ تَلْدَغُ الرَّجُلُ لَدْغَةً يَسْرِي سُمُّهَا فِي جَسَدِهِ 70 عَامًا ثُمَّ يَتَفَتَّتْ لَحْمُهُ عَنْ عَضْمِهِ. He said, these snakes and the scorpions. Even Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam described in other hadith that the scorpion on the size of the mule bigger than the donkey. He said this, they sting him only once. The poison will boil in his body 70 years. Then after that, his flesh will crack. Now let us come to the top of the line in two surah in the Quran. And subhanAllah, ya ikhwan, the two surah, the same tertib. If we understand the tafsir of the Quran, wallahi, the Quran is ajib, ya ikhwan. The first mentioning of those, they are going to al-Firdaws al-A'la in Surah Al-Mu'minun. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Qad aflaha al-mu'minun. What's their sifat? Alladhina hum fi salatihim khashi'un. Look at the tertib of the sifat. Pay attention. الذين هم في صلاتهم خاشعون والذين هم عن اللغو معرضون والذين هم للزكاة فاعلون والذين هم لفروجهم حافظون إلا على أزواجهم أو ما ملكت أيمانهم فإنهم غير ملومين فمن ابتغى وراء ذلك فأولئك هم العادون والذين هم لأماناتهم وعهدهم راعون. He comes back. والذين هم على صلواتهم يحافظون. Start with the salah. Ends with the salah. Then after that. والذين هم على صلواتهم يحافظون أولئك هم الوارثون الذين يرثون الفردوس هم فيها خالدون. سبحان الله يا أخوان. Start with the salah and again remind you about the salah. Why في صلاتهم then على صلاتهم؟ في صلاتهم concentration and devotion, خضوع وخشوع. على صلواتهم the timing of the salah, the wudu of the salah. So على outside the salah, في inside the salah. The same ترتيب in سورة المعارج.
إن الإنسان خلق هلوعا إذا مسه الشر جزوعا وإذا مسه الخير منوعا إلا المصلين.
Now, no, no, accept المصلين. إلا المصلين. وهم the مصلين.
الذين هم على صلاتهم دائمون والذين في أموالهم حق معلوم للسائل والمحروم والذين يصدقون بيوم الدين والذين هم من عذاب ربهم مشفقون إن عذاب ربهم غير مأمون والذين هم لأماناتهم وعهدهم راعون والذين هم بشهاداتهم قائمون والذين هم على صلاتهم يحافظون.
استرد الصلاة إن بدأ الصلاة.
أولئك في جنات مكرمون.
سبحان الله. طيب why start with the صلاة and end with the صلاة؟ صفات المؤمن صلاة 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 صلاة. Let me give you an example. Brother Ahmed Pasha is my friend since, you can say, 17, 18 years from Connecticut. And I know him before that even. He visited me. So this man is very dear to me and he is a very respected man. Jazallah khair. And I want to make ikram for him. So I told my brother Haytham, and he's another friend, mashallah, mashallah, my friends on the right and left. You see, bodyguards we have here. So don't even come close to me. We have bodyguards here. So he's a very respected friend of mine. I know him about 20 years. But he's still young, mashallah. So I told him, yeah, Haytham, you are young. Go to the market because this man is elder. You know, we respect the elders. We tell them elders. We don't tell them old people. So he's elder. He's a respected man and he's visiting me. Please go to the market and the main thing in my list is the meat. Because if I bring him any food other than the meat, it's disrespect, right? Pakora, disrespect for the mehman. Pakora hai, dal hai, keema hai, sheer khurma hai. It does not work. But we want biryani hai. مرغی ہے بالکل ٹھیک ہے صحیح. So I tell him, listen, go bring me 10 kilo meat. You know, the Arab, our meat is big sizes. One of the brothers always inviting us his meat like this. I said, ya akhi, put some meat. He said, no, we have meat. I told him, ya akhi, your meat, we have to Google it. Okay, so give us meat, ya akhi. So I told him, listen, or I tell my son, listen, my son, go to the market and bring us meat. And by the way, when you are coming, bring us a bread, yogurt, tomato for the... Then at the end they say, listen, huh? Don't forget the meat, right? Because the main thing is the meat. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us the same thing. قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي صَلَاتِهِمْ وَالَّذِينَ 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 هُمْ عَلَى صَلَاتِهِمْ. You see? So, because it's so important, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala starts with it and ends with it. So, my brothers, from the ahadith, whosoever pray 5 times, he will go to Jannah. And whosoever does not pray 5 times, he will go to Jahannam. Simple. Wal-iyadu billah. Now, because they told me 15 minutes, and the mashayikh, when they catch the microphone, they forgive themselves. And today, alhamdulillah, Saturday. And if somebody wants to leave, brothers, you don't need permission. Just ma'a salama. You don't need permission. Because sometimes we talk more than the time frame. So may Allah forgive me. Let me, because they want to talk about Salat al-Fajr, let me tell you two ahadith. One of them will save you from Jahannam and one will take you to Jannah. عن أبي موسى الأشعري رضي الله تعالى عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من صلى البردين دخل الجنة. Whosoever pray البردين. البردين means the two cool ones. Why رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم mentioned الفجر and the عصر, they are the cool ones. The ulama, they said because the فجر is the coolest time for the night. And the Asr is the coolest time for the day. So whosoever pray al-Fajr and the Asr, he will go to Jannah. And the other hadith that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, لَنْ يَلِي جَنَّارَ أَحَدٌ صَلَّى قَبْلَ طُلُوعِ الشَّمْسِ وَقَبْلَ غُرُوبِهَا. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, a person prays before sun rises. And before sunset, he will never go to Jahannam. He will never enter Jahannam. Whosoever pray al-Fajr and Asr. But does not mean you pray only two times a day. Because this is the most difficult salawat. And by the way, al-Asr, the least number in any masjid al-Asr. Go to al-Asr and see. Come here to al-Asr and see. To any place, Al-Asr is the most busy day. The person is working, then he is very tired, he's going home. So whosoever pray before the sun rises, before the sunset, he will never go to Jahannam. Now what's my responsibility? Alhamdulillah, look, today is Saturday, ya ikhwan, right? Is there any school today? Is there any school today? No, right? Every one of you has at least two or three kids, right? I have six, alhamdulillah. Wallahi, I wanted more, but my wife, she said, that's it. But I want more, wallahi. You know what my wish was when I was young? But still wish. I wish to have 30 children. Boys. The girls, they can't be imam. And I want them, every one of them, to lead one night of Taraweeh, and I am behind them to correct them. Wallahi, this is my wish. But inshallah, Allah will write it in my scale. It's just wishes. My wife tell me, okay, just wish. Okay, jazakallah khair. That's it. Live with wish. But anyway, صلوا على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. So my brothers, my point now, every one of you have 1, 2, 3, 4 kids. Where's your kids? If we have 200 people now here, we should have at least 400 children there praying al-Fajr. 6:30 al-Fajr. When you are bringing them, when the Fajr becomes 9 o'clock in the morning or 10 o'clock? Bring them. Yesterday I told you tricks to bring them, then tell them we are going to Dunkin' Donut after that. Wallah, Dunkin' Donut around you will have very good business. They will give me 10% of bringing them. Ya Ikhwan, bring your children with you, especially al-Fajr. I remember, the most thing I remember with my father when he used to take me to al-Fajr, to al-Masjid. This is click in my mind. Say, make dua, may Allah forgive my father. And may Allah entitle him to be from Ahl Firdaus Ya Rabbi. Allahumma aghfir lahu warham. ولسائر أموات المسلمين يا رب العالمين. Say Ameen. So my brothers, every one of us has children. Why don't you bring your children with you? You have 15 years old. You have 16. You have 9. You have 10. Bring them with you, ya. Let them pray al-Fajr. Anyway. So our responsibility when we go back from Fajr, if we don't bring them to al-Fajr, to wake up our family. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَأْمُرْ أَهْلَكَ بِالصَّلَاةِ. Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he used to go back to his family from Fajr and he used to tell them, قُومُوا إِلَى نَارِكُمْ فَأَطْفِئُوهَا. Wake up, wake up, extinguish your fire. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praised Sayyidina Ismail alayhi salam.
وَاذْكُرْ فِي الْكِتَابِ إِسْمَعِيلِ إنه كان صادق الوعد وكان رسولا نبيا وكان يأمر أهله بالصلاة والزكاة وكان عند ربه مرضيا.
الله سبحانه وتعالى said, remember Ismail, he used to order his family to make salah. وكان يأمر أهله بالصلاة. I will finish
with a story in our country. Old man, over 60s, not old man, but anyway. So he became a prayer after 60s. He started praying. So he heard, you know, you should order your family, you should. Then after the salah, he said to the brothers of the masjid, brothers, let us make mashura, consultation, my situation. Okay. He said, I have a wife, but she does not pray and she does not want to pray. What should I do? We have very fast solution. Very fast solution. واحد قال له طلقها يا زلمة. Just divorce her. One of the elders. Just divorce her. Are you crazy? We have been together more than 30 years. I have 10 children. What should I? Then one of the wise people, he said, does your wife like the money? He said, of course, all the wives like money. No money, no honey. That's what you're talking about. Always look, subhanAllah, if your car, your wife's car better than your car. Your wife's cell phone better than your cell phone. This is normal. Okay? He said, how's your situation? He said, okay. He said, why don't you offer her Fajr dinar, Dhuhr dinar, Asr dinar, Maghrib dinar, Isha dinar. This is about 40 years ago, 5 dinar every day, the salary of teacher in Jordan. The salary of teacher is very good. So he came back to his house. MashaAllah, he has now a plan. Assalamu alaikum. Alaikum assalam. What do you want? He said, Ya Muhammad. She said, yes. He said, Salah. He said, listen. When you go to Jannah, lock the door behind you. A'udhu billah. قال لما تفوت الجنة سكر الباب وراك. She does not want to go to Jannah with him even. A'udhu billah. He said, no. I have a new plan. She said, what's the plan? He said, Fajr dinar, Dhuhr dinar, Asr dinar, Maghrib dinar, Isha dinar. She said, huh? Repeat again. MashaAllah. So he repeated again. They are Bedouins. She told him, you know, the Bedouins, instead of saying deal, they said, put your hand in your mustache. You know, and Bedouins means if you don't keep your word, you should shave it, you are not man anymore. Okay? So this is their custom. قالت له امسك على شنبك. He said, MashaAllah, خلاص. Means deal. Okay. He said, SubhanAllah, next day, she was on the prayer rug before him. MashaAllah, wallahi, the dinar is good. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi. He said, this is the dinar. Dhuhr dinar, Asr dinar, Maghrib dinar. 40 days. MashaAllah, she's praying. After 40 days, he came to the mashayikh. He said, mashayikh? They said, yes. He said, mashura. They asked him, what happened? Did she stop praying? He said, no, I don't have money anymore. Oh, mashallah. What should I do? Then they told him, listen, you have done your side. You pray 2 rak'at, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. SubhanAllah, by the way, this is a true story, my brothers. I don't make up stories. This is a true story. So he prayed 2 rak'at and said, Ya Rab, this is my capability. What should I do? Tomorrow she will pray, no salah, no money, she will stop praying. He was worried. That night, 2 angels came in her dream. One of them asked her, do you pray? She said, yes, I pray. The other angel, he said, she is lying. She is praying for the dinar. So he told him, give me the stick. So they beat her up in the dream. That man, he swore upon Allah. Next day, the marks of the sticks on her body. So he does not know about anything. In the morning, she said, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. There's no money. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Then she put her hand, I'm good, jaybiha, here. And she gave him all the money, 40 days. خذ فلوسك. Take your money from today. أنا أصلي لله رب العالمين. She said, take your money back. I will not take anything from you. From today, I am praying to Allah رب العالمين. So my brothers, why we are forcing the angels to use the stick? Use it yourself. No, I'm just joking. Just joking. I'm just joking. So my brothers, we need to use the hikmah. Saturday, Sunday, when you see your family, they are sleeping. Why don't you be humble enough to wake them up while you, alhamdulillah, already prayed in the Fajr in the masjid. You go back, see them sleeping, wake them up, do the breakfast. You, every time your wife making the breakfast, wake, make it once a week. Ah, you'll tell me I don't know how to cook. You will learn the two eggs needs project. I will teach you how to cook, you know. So make the breakfast yourself. Prepare them the breakfast when they see, mashallah, our father is preparing the breakfast, mashallah, very nice. So with hikmah, read at night with them the virtues of the salah. Imagine, let me just give you an example about sunnah al-fajr, not the fard. This is the sunnah only. If somebody, I'm going tomorrow to Houston, inshallah. Tomorrow I'm going to Houston. If somebody going to Houston, I will not rent a car, I will go with him. And if somebody does not have enough money and he's going to Houston, I will rent a car and he will go with me free. So tomorrow I'm going to Houston. Imagine if somebody in Houston, brothers from here, 278 miles, because I went last month the same thing, 278 miles from here to Houston. If somebody announced on the newspaper that he has Mercedes, 2015, 15,000 miles, and he has a problem with his wife, and he wants to sell it $5,000, the value of the car, of course, it's about $50,000. So, 4-hour drive, and you will gain about, at least, if you sell it in the black market, you will get $30,000 profit. How many of you willing to go, but you have to be there at 5 in the morning? How many of you willing to go? I am willing to go. MashaAllah, all of you muttaqeen. No, I am willing to go. All of us, we will go. True or not true? How about if somebody offer us $1 million in Houston? If somebody offers me from here to Houston to walking and gives me $10 million, wallahi al-azim, I will walk. What's the problem? I will walk. Whenever I become tired, I will sit down, pass by Dunkin' Donut, take the coffee. By the way, I don't drink coffee. I'm just joking with you. When I came to this country, I have seen everybody the coffee. Akhi, I have headache, I need coffee. I said, the coffee will make you addicted like this. I will never drink coffee. Now I drink tea once in a while. So I'm not addicted to the coffee. When you want your coffee, I don't have coffee. So if somebody offers me or offers you $10 million and to go walking, I will go walking. And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us the two rak'at of fajr more precious than this dunya and what it contains. One building, ya ikhwan, I live in New York, one building in Manhattan, $25 billion building in Manhattan. How about all Manhattan? How about all New York? How about all the United States? How about all this earth with this world? Not even coming to the two rak'at of sunnah. And subhanallah, we are willing to wake up at 5 to go to the work, and that work maximum will give us $300 a day. We are willing to wake up for that, and we are not willing to wake up to come to the house of Allah to pray al-fajr. In the ghazwat of Khandaq, I will finish with this. Ghazwat al-Khandaq. The Muslims, they win the battle, and they have booty, al-ghanaim. Then one of the Sahaba was very smart. So he started taking, buying and selling in the same day. He takes because something and you take it free. He knows the value. So he starts selling, buying. At the end of the day, he said, Ya Rasulullah, I made a profit. No one made a profit like me. Then Rasulullah asked him, what did you do? He said, I start buying, selling from the Sahaba. I made 300 pounds of silver in one day. 300 pounds of silver. Then Rasulullah s.a.w. replied, Wallahi inni la a'lamu rajulan amila aqalla mink wa rabiha akthara mink. He said, Wallahi, I know a man. He worked less than you and made profit more than you. Who is he, ya Rasulullah? Then he said, a man made wudu in his house and came and prayed duha in the masjid, 2 rak'at. You see? Subhanallah, the people ask something and Rasulullah SAW direct him to the other thing. You know, the Sahaba, they ask in Rasulullah SAW, يَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ الْأَهِلَّةِ. They are asking you about the hilal. The hilal starts small, then big, then big, then moon, right? يَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ الْأَهِلَّةِ. Allah Azza wa Jalla did not tell them it starts small and becomes full moon. No, he said, قُلْ هِيَ مَوَاقِتُ لِلنَّاسِ وَالْحَجِ. So Allah Azza wa Jalla always directing us to the work, not to the information, work, you see. So may Allah Azza wa Jalla give us tawfiq. And I can feel the people, they start coughing, means, خلاص, جزاكَ خير. You know, when they visit, means Allah يعطيك العافية جزاك الله خير enough. You know, so may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the understanding and tawfiq. After Dhuhr inshallah we have درس for the youth, and all of you youth by the way, alhamdulillah, you are young, right? We will talk about the time, the value of the time in the life of the Muslim inshallah. And tomorrow very important درس, our relationship with Allah, how can we tie it and come close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. جزاكم الله أحسن الجزاء وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وبارك وسلم. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين.